Hi, this video is going to look at a nonparametric statistical test called the Wilcoxon test. And the Wilcoxon test is used to determine whether two dependent samples were selected from populations that have the same distribution. So, doing this test, we'll begin by identifying the claim, stating the null and alternative hypotheses, identifying an alpha level, and determining our sample size. We'll then find our critical value from our table, and then we'll calculate our test statistic. This is going to involve completing a table with these headers. So we'll have sample 1 and sample 2 laid out, and then next to that, their difference. Next to that, their absolute rank, our value rather, their rank, and their signed rank. Based on that, we make a decision to reject or fail to reject the null, and then we'll interpret the decision in the context of the original claim. Here's an example of the Wilcoxon signed rank test. A medical researcher wants to determine whether a new drug affects the number of headache hours experienced by headache sufferers. And to do so, he selects 7 patients and asks each to give the number of headache hours per day they are experiencing before and after taking the drug. So the results are shown in the table with the 0.05 level. We want to know, can the researcher conclude that the new drug affected the number of hours? So the null is that the drug does not affect the number of hours, and the alternative, which is the claim, is that the drug does affect the number of headache hours. So this is a two-tailed test with a alpha 0.05 and n equal to 7. And from that, we can find our critical value. And then we'll set up our table with our sample 1 and sample 2 comparison. Look at the difference, the absolute value, rank, and signed rank. And the average of the rank, 5, 6, and 7, is used for this. The sum of the negative ranks is negative 6, and the sum of the positive ranks is 22. Our test statistic is going to be the smaller of the absolute value of the two sums. So in this case, 6 is the smaller, and that was the negative sign. And that is greater than the critical value of 2, so we're going to fail to reject the null. And in the context of the original claim, there's not enough evidence at the 5% level to support the claim that the drug affects the number of headache hours. Another variation of the Wilcoxon test is the rank sum test. And it's another nonparametric test. It can be used to determine whether two independent samples were selected from populations having the same distribution. So here the difference, of course, is now we're focusing on independent rather than dependent samples. So one of the requirements for this test is the sample sizes must be at least 10 for both. N represents the size of the smaller sample, and 1 that is, and N2 the size of the larger sample. So when calculating the sum of the ranks R, we're going to use the ranks for the smaller of the two samples. So with two independent samples, the test statistic Z for this rank sum test is equal to the R, the sum of ranks, minus the average rank, divided by the standard deviation of the ranks, where R is the sum of the ranks for the smaller sample, recall. And the average rank is found by taking N1, the sample size for the first sample, and multiplying that by the pooled sample plus 1, so taking the two samples and adding them together plus 1, and then dividing that whole thing by 2. That's going to give us the average of the two samples. And finally, finding the standard deviation, we take the product of the two sample sizes, multiply that by the pooled sample sizes plus 1, and divide that by 12. And finally, we take the square root of all of that. So here are the steps for the Wilcoxon rank sum test. First, identify our claim. Again, the HO and HA. Specify the alpha level of significance. Find the critical value using our table. Determine the sample sizes. And remember that N1 has to be smaller or equal to N2. We then find the sum of the ranks for the smaller sample, R. And so we have to list the combined data in ascending order, rank them, and add the sum of the ranks for the smaller sample. So then we do our test statistic using the previously mentioned equation. And from there, we make a decision to reject or fail to reject the null hypothesis and interpret the decision in the context of the original claim. Here's an example of the Wilcoxon Ranksum Test. An industry analyst claims there's no difference in the salaries earned by workers in the manufacturing and construction industries. A random sample of 10 manufacturing and 10 construction workers is drawn and their salaries recorded in the thousands here. And at the 0.1 level, we want to know, can we reject the analyst's claim? So the null, there's no difference between the salaries. The alternative, there is a difference between the salaries. That's a two-tailed test. So we use, at the 0.10 level, the critical values for z are negative 1.645 and positive 1.645. And so the rejection regions are found within those, outside of those, rather. And to find the values of R, the mean rank, and the standard deviation of the rank, we have to construct our table that shows the combined data in ascending order with corresponding ranks. Here's that table. So there's the ordered data, the sample, you know, which industry are they in, the rank. And then we continue on here. Now the samples are the same size, so N1 and N2 are equal. So if we let N1 be the sample of construction workers and R is the sum of construction rankings, in this case that works out to 74.5. N1 is equal to 10, as is N2. So we find the mean rank and standard deviation rank with these equations, as mentioned before. So the values are 105 and 13.23, respectively. So with that, when R is 74.5 with a mean rank of 105 and standard deviation of 13.23, our test statistic, when we plug those values in, comes out to minus 2.31. That is less than the critical value, so we do reject the HO. So there is enough evidence at the 10% level to reject the claim that there's no difference in the salaries earned by the workers in each of these respective industries.